Being in the middle is safe, but does it provide any opportunity in business today? So you might have heard me say on several occasions that the middle is washing out in business today. But the truth is, the middle is boring. And in today's competitive environment, the middle is logjammed, worse than any point in history because of the proliferation of brand creation, just a ton of brands that are getting created because of low barriers of entry. If a consumer looks at your brand and doesn't understand why they're spending money with you over your dozens or hundreds of competitors that are substitutes to you, you're in trouble. This is honestly the trouble that you're seeing a ton with legacy brands. Decade ago, they were competing with a handful or two of competitors that was in this sea of sameness. And because of that, they won enough of that market share to survive. Now, with a slightly bigger market, I think sometimes people forget that the categories in which I am talking about, things like nutritional supplements or sports nutrition or protein bars or energy drinks, they're growing. So that market has gotten bigger, but the amount of competitors, the amount of substitutes available in the market has created this environment that has left legacy brands struggling to get their share of that larger market. So with them kind of being a lot larger and maybe being less nimble, they're struggling to survive in this environment. And the answer seems to be with a lot of these legacy businesses is to focus on incrementally improving in this hopes that they can extend the runway. I think anybody in business, you know, will agree that something's better than nothing. But what I think a lot of these brands struggle with is that they believe they always have like time. There's always an element of time. They'll be able to figure it out. But as you've seen recently in a ton of different businesses, you're seeing closures. You're seeing a ton of bankruptcies. You're seeing businesses that have been around for a long period of time closing their doors because they just no longer can extend that runway enough. So how do you get out of this, like, sea of sameness? How do you get out of the middle? You know, it has to start somewhere, but where do you start? When we're talking about getting out of the middle, we're moving towards one of the ends of the spectrum. So when I talk about some of these areas in which you can move to the ends of the spectrum, you'll see for most that I'll give examples to kind of get you towards one way or the other. So first one we're talking about is product. Start a product here. We are talking a lot about consumer packaged goods here. We are talking about physical products. So I think it's important for us to start at the product. First idea, one that you're starting to see a lot more of, but you hadn't really seen until maybe this idea of like Amazon private labeling started to happen. But we're talking about economical products. So I get it, it's not sexy. You know, going out and building a economical product line, a low cost product line is not sexy. But remember that Walmart, you know, the largest retailer in the world, set out to create a retailer around low cost economical products for a section of customers that has continuously grown since its inception. On the other side of that, we're talking about like premium products. Now, in some consumer goods categories, they have very well established premium products, premium goods. But for a lot of like the consumer packaged goods industry, you don't have as much of an established premium product category. And that might be because of the usage rates and people making some, you know, cost-benefit type of analysis when they're doing things with a consumer packaged good or maybe even like a fast-moving consumer good. That's a little bit different than if you're going to buy maybe handbags or sneakers where you're not really buying those daily, weekly, monthly. But I still think there is an availability for premium products and building out premium products. As long as you can complete the loop of the experience and everything, there's a place on that side of the spectrum in today's market. Now with products, two other kind of areas to maybe look at. One, targeted. So this idea of like taking fragments of the market that are happening at a fast pace and building out businesses around those. And at this point, you're seeing fragments happen quicker and fragments of fragments happening quicker than normal. So there's availability to get into those as long as you're nimble enough to do it. And then another kind of area to think about from a product standpoint is this idea of like outlandish products. So we're talking about this social media generation and their seeking of maybe Instagrammable type of things. So everybody's looking for the strongest, the biggest, the most outlandish products possible to show off and talk about. On the other side, we're talking about branding here. Like, how can you stand out, maybe branding, get yourself out of the middle? So again, on the economical side, we're talking about private label. We're talking about very basic, stripped down brands. You're seeing brandless having a whole platform, a whole digital marketplace around their private label, very basic products. Every retailer at this point has multiple private labels. They have private label brand fragments, some that are a little bit closer to what we would consider like a branded product. Then you have ones that are just super stripped down. So you're seeing a lot of opportunity with this, especially with some of the cost layers getting eliminated with maybe direct to consumer or Amazon. Now again, on the flip side of that, the other side of the spectrum, we're talking premium branding, filling the rest of that experience. On the premium side, we're talking about with the products, making sure you have premium brand elements, you are really focused on premium packaging, presenting yourself in a premium position that customers feel like they're luxurious, they feel like they are a part of this elitist club. Now just with product, kind of same little targeted areas, you also have the ability to do branding. From a targeted, fragmented sense, you can really just, at this point with digital, it's really just talk to like one category of buyers, one very small type of profile. And then again, with like outlandish branding, you are creating a brand around kind of some crazy elements, contemporary subjects, or things that are happening in the world, and you're trying to polarize people so they self-select in or out within your brand. Now, another way to get out of the middle is to utilize like technology. So I'm not gonna necessarily talk about maybe the low-end side of technology. I think that at this point, availability of cheap economical goods and having stripped down digital marketplaces and things that can provide you with that is already available in the market. I don't think there's really any differentiation that you can make on that level. So we're gonna be talking about kind of the more specialized or premium viewpoint within getting out of the middle. One is around personalization. I think in the categories that I specifically talk about, like food, beverage, nutritional supplements, a lot of this focus is around personalization and getting as close as possible to a truly unique offering one-to-one to the customer. So if you're able to attack that and able to execute on that, you're going to be able to stand out. This idea of like integration of maybe some technologies, if you're able to bring together some already established habits to create this like network effect, you're able to kind of position your brand close to another technology or close to some other behavior that's already happening in the world, and that's able to kind of pull you to that integration partner's at. And then this element of disrupt the way consumers buy your product, interact with your product. If you look at a company like Dirty Lemon, you know, their commerce is done through mobile, through text messaging. So that's something that's kind of makes you stand out within the crowd, makes you look very unique. And then the last area to kind of get yourself out of the middle is this element, kind of talked about it with the technology side of things, but to look at this different way with like strategic partnerships. A few years ago, I explored with a client this idea of how do you utilize something like a Lyft or an Uber to be able to push your products. And what you'll see now is that you have, you know, a company like Snack Nation and Cargo that have kind of partnered together to do like in-car goods when you are in Lyfts and Ubers in some areas. They're still kind of testing out some of this, but again, that puts you in a position, you're putting yourself connected to position yourself outside the middle. This is not, you know, kind of the boring middle, see the same processes, strategies that a lot of other brands are doing. So it makes consumers view you differently. So though there's tons of probably other ideas that I could have thrown out there to get your brand to think about getting out of the middle, and with all these constant fragments and fragments of fragments, there's always new spectrum also get out of the middle from. So this is going to be a constant evolution. The world is changing very quickly, and the more that you understand that change is constant, the better your business is going to be in this environment. And I think it's important to just kind of end on something that I say all the time. That's the fact that if you are a business, brand, whatever it is, and you're trying to appeal to everybody, you're going to end up appealing to nobody. Thank you so much for watching this video. If you want to help support me, make sure you guys hit that thumbs up button on this video. If this is the first time you've been introduced to my videos. Would love for you guys to be a part of my community by subscribing to my channel. I upload several videos just like this weekly. And if you guys want to connect further outside of this platform, I do include all of my social media links down below. I just want to thank you guys again for your time. Hopefully I gave you some value in return, and we'll see you guys on the next video.